If you've been following my YouTube channel this year, you are undoubtedly aware of the fact that I am one of those old school Canon DSLR owners and users. I've been using 5Ds, 6Ds, and 7Ds for over a decade now. I love Canon cameras, and I'm one of those people that has just been super excited about the new R5 and the R6, so much so that I've made a few videos about them so far this year, including one from like 2 or 3 weeks ago, when Canon announced availability of the cameras. They announced you can now pre-order them, and they put out all the specs, and I made a video about it. And at the end of that video, I shared my intent of what it was that I was planning to do, which was to pre-order the new R5. Well, a lot can change in a couple of weeks, because between that video and the one you're looking at right now, I ended up canceling my pre-order for the R5. I'm not pre-ordering the R6 either. As a matter of fact, I'm not pre-ordering anything right now. I decided to wait a little bit longer. And in this video, what I want to do is I want to share with you why I decided to wait and why it may be in the best interest of other people who may be in a similar situation to me, people who are looking to upgrade from, you know, their DSLRs or are considering the R5 or the R6, that maybe it would be in your best interest just to wait a little bit longer. My name is Todd Dominey. I make videos here on YouTube about photography. Okay, why make a video about canceling a pre-order for a camera, which admittedly is a rather silly topic for a video, but the way I see it, I have a responsibility because I have an audience here on YouTube. I've been putting out videos this whole year about the R5 and the R6. I've been sharing my excitement about the cameras. So I think it's really important if something changes and if your perspective changes and if you change your mind about something to be upfront about it and to put that information out and let other people decide for themselves what it is that they're going to do when it comes to their own purchasing decisions. Okay, without further ado, why did I cancel my pre-order for the R5? Okay, well, if you have been following news about the R5 and the R6 lately here on YouTube, you are undoubtedly aware of the fact that both of these cameras have issues with overheating when it comes to recording video in high quality 4K modes and up from there 8K on the R5. And when I say overheating issues, what I'm talking about is the fact that you can record like 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, and then the camera physically shuts off. And not only do you have to turn the camera off, but you have to leave the camera off for upwards of 20, 30 minutes or even longer before you can power it back on and start recording video again. Now, it's important to note, if you don't care about video, then this doesn't affect you. There's no overheating when taking photos or when shooting in the 1080 modes on these cameras. It's only when shooting in 4K and above that you start seeing these problems. Now, the reaction to this has been hyperbolic. It's not a big deal at all. Cameras overheat all the time. Then you had people saying, well, you know, who really records video longer than 15 minutes anyway? Valid point, but obviously there's people like me and plenty of other people who record for much longer. Then you had some people who said, no way, no how, there's no way I could use either the R5 or the R6. And then you had another argument, which for me is like one of the most awesome and ridiculous arguments that you will find. There actually is not an overheating issue. There's technically no issue with the R5 and the R6 because Canon was forthright with information to their credit about how long you can expect to shoot in 4K mode on both the R5 and the R6. So the cameras are performing according to spec. They're performing the way that Canon says they should be performing. So in essence, technically speaking, there is no issue, which ultimately means it's a feature, not a bug. And this went back and forth for a while, and then in the middle of it, Sony dropped a bomb with the most immaculate timing. They announced the Sony A7S III, another new full-frame mirrorless camera, but this one designed for video. This one designed especially for 4K video. It's not a photography camera because it only has 12 megapixels, not a particularly good camera for stills, but for video, it's exactly what videographers want who are recording 4K video because there's no internal record time limit. You can record over 30 minutes. Canon R5 and R6 are limited to 30. And they are not as susceptible to overheating as the R5 and the R6. Some people have been getting the Sonys to overheat in certain situations. But from all the tests that I've seen and all the different videos that I've watched, it appears that the Sony is nowhere near as susceptible to heat and to shutdowns as the R5 and the R6. And this has placed Canon in a really awkward position with both the R5 and the R6. And I'm starting to see people out there saying, well, you know, it's the fault of Canon PR and marketing because they're not selling the cameras right, they're not marketing them correctly, they're not targeting the right audience. And I think there's some truth to that, but I think the issue is actually more systemic. Here's what I think is going wrong. I think what's happening is that internally inside of Canon, there has been some kind of disconnect between product and engineering and design and user experience when it comes to how these cameras were designed. And I say that because I think in some ways Canon decided that, you know, with the R5 and the R6, they were going to, again, do a moonshot. They were going to just ramp up the specs. They were going to silence all the critics who said that Canon doesn't take video seriously anymore. They haven't taken it seriously since the Canon 5D Mark II. And here they are basically, you know, silencing all their critics with "How you like me now?" AK raw on the R5. But the problem that has apparently occurred is not enough attention given to the actual user experience of the cameras. What is it that the audience of people who care about 4K and AK, what else do they care about? What else is important to them? It's not just specs. It's not just the resolution that the camera is capable of capturing. It comes down to, ultimately, the usability of the camera, because if the camera is not usable, people are not going to use it. And then most likely you had engineering getting back to product and saying, yeah, sure, you can, you know, record 8K. We can do that. We can do 4K as well. However, we can't change the body. We can't change the design of the body. We can't change the mechanics of it. It is the way that it is. So if you want to shoot 8K and 4K, it has to be done with the current hardware. It has to be done with how the cameras are designed. We can't be making huge changes like putting vents and fans into them and making the camera body bigger and all that kind of stuff. But what we can do, if you really want it, we can put limits on it. We can limit the amount of time to prevent the camera from overheating, to prevent it from malfunctioning and causing more problems. Then product is able to check the box and saying, we support 8K, we support high quality 4K, 120 frames per second, all of that. They can claim that, but the user experience obviously is not what people were expecting. And so obviously I feel rather conflicted about all of this because I was so excited about the R5 because I wanted to be shooting video with it. I wanted to be doing some photography with it. But right now, because I'm an American and people are not letting Americans into their countries right now, it's kind of hard to be doing any kind of substantive traveling and, you know, working on my portfolio, my landscape photography portfolio. That's kind of off the table right now. So having a better, higher resolution camera is not something I absolutely need. So all of that is what ultimately led me to canceling the pre-order for the R5, and for that matter, canceling any intention of pre-ordering anything right now, because everything is moving so fast and so quick right now in the camera industry. Who knows what's going to happen with the R5 and the R6 next? Is Canon actually going to release firmware updates? Are they going to see this as a problem? Are they going to do some kind of recall? Are they going to do Rev2 versions of these cameras? Or, on top of all that, is Canon going to continue this trend? And are they going to come out with a high resolution? This is what I ultimately want. A high resolution R5S, or whatever you want to call it, super high resolution full frame mirrorless camera without all the video specs. Just get video out of it altogether, as far as I care. Make a high resolution full frame camera that is ideally suited for landscape photography. That would be amazing, and that would be the camera that I would be most excited about. And then of course there's Sony with the a7s3. Lots of positive early buzz on the camera right now, but who knows what it's actually going to be like when it hits the streets and when people actually start using it. So there you go. That's everything that I've been thinking about with regard to all these recent developments on the R5 and the R6. Hope I didn't bore you to death, but I at least wanted to share up-to-date information about what my plans are. But what do you think? I mean, did I make a mistake by canceling the R5? Do you have an R5? Are you using it? Do you love it? What are your plans? Are you thinking about getting the Sony? I would love to hear from you. Leave a comment below and let me know your thoughts. So obviously it's starting to get dark here, so I need to wrap this up. Quick program note, coming up this Sunday, I'm going to be posting part two of the four-part video series that I'm currently making about shooting video using the Canon M50. This next part, part two, is going to be about lenses, EFM lenses for the M50. So if you're interested in that, please remember to subscribe to this channel and also hit the notifications bell if you'd like to be notified when that video is released. That is it for me, everyone. It's about time for me to head in. I will see you next time.